Hello everyone, this is Dr. Rahul Pandya. Welcome to our channel. In today's episode, we will discuss the basic concept of plagiarism and its consequences. Before we begin, if you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe and hit the bell icon to receive the latest videos notifications. Also, if you find the episode informative, please do not forget to like and share. You may follow us on Facebook and Instagram. The links are posted in the description. Plagiarism occurs when we copy someone else's ideas and present them as ours without citing the sources. The common reasons behind the plagiarism are time pressure, approaching the deadlines, lack of awareness, exam period, thesis submission in a hurry, or peer pressure to publish more articles in shorter period for a professional growth. Depending on the plagiarism severity, the penalty for such instances would be decided. One will face mild consequences if the plagiarism is unintentional, such as minor text copying, self-plagiarism, or any other accidental plagiarism. In such minor cases, the committee may request the author to submit an apology letter or an explanation along with the correction. However, there are severe occurrences of plagiarism, such as copyright violations, stealing the idea, severe copying, or duplications. In such cases, we face severe consequences of plagiarism, such as expulsion from the institute, authors may be blacklisted and barred from the future article submissions, retraction or withdrawal of the article, the university may also cancel the degree of alumni, fired from the current job, criminal charges, etc. In academics, we face many instances where students are found committing plagiarism when submitting the assignments, term paper, lab reports, etc. They copy from other students' work. They also copy the previously submitted assignment to the new assignment in the same or another course. When writing the research papers or thesis, in general, students copy from the electronic sources, research papers, books, journals, etc. without citing the sources. Universities consider the reported plagiarism cases as severe offenses and process them through the disciplinary committee. For intentional plagiarism, the disciplinary committee may award a warning, recommends a degradation of the awarded grade, award a fail grade, expulsion from the institute, etc. The university may also penalize alumni by canceling the awarded degree in severe cases. The same may be notified to the current employer of the respective alumni, which will result in a loss of job. Now, we will discuss the consequences of copyright violations. Intellectual property rights are protected through the Copyright Acts. Breach of Copyright Acts may result in legal consequences. The original authors holding the copyrights may claim their IPRs and demand ratification for the breach of the copyrights. In case of accidental copyright violations, some mild consequences demand apology letters, imposing financial penalties, or transferring the entire profit gained through the commercial activities. In case of intentional copyright violations, we may face severe consequences, such as losing a current job, future job applications may be denied, the authors may be banned from publishing, legal proceedings, imprisonment, etc. Plagiarism occurs in the following instances when we do not cite the sources. Students copy from the available sources when submitting the assignments, laboratory reports, term papers, project reports, research articles, dissertations, theses, etc. Plagiarism occurs when we completely or partially copy an idea from any internet source. Oral consent is not sufficient when we use someone else's work or content without written permission from the respective content owner. When we use images, graphs, pictures, charts, graphics, musics, videos, or any other multimedia material without written approvals from the copyright holders. There are certain academic misconducts that we need to be aware of. Following are the frequent occurrences of the academic misconducts. Considering the collaborative research, when we misuse the research data without taking the written consent from the respective collaborators and publishing the work by removing their names or reordering the author's numbers by placing our name first and others' names later, even if their contribution is substantial. Purchase of any pre-written material and publishing as our own. Publishing a research paper, book, or book chapter which is partially or entirely copied from someone else's work. Asking someone else to write a research paper, thesis, project report, assignment, laboratory report, etc. for us. When we force others to include our name as a co-author in any research article, book, or any form of publication. Removing the name of other contributors and publishing the article under our sole authorship. Multi-posting by communicating previously submitted work to any other platform. In other words, submitting one paper to many other journals. Inappropriate citations, not citing appropriate sources due to lack of awareness, lack of time, laziness, ignorance, etc. Generating fake plagiarism reports to satisfy the university's mandates by pasting text as a snapshot and running through the plagiarism checkers. Fabricating graphs, results, tables, surveys, numbers, or statistics by self-judgment without performing the actual work, experiments, simulation studies, or field surveys. Reusing self-published work from the previously submitted grant proposals or research papers. Presenting the translated work from the original language to another without citing the sources. Thank you very much for attending this episode. We will be creating new videos on research process regularly. Please subscribe to our channel to get notifications of the latest videos. Before we leave, please do not forget to like and share the episode. Thank you very much.